Hi everyone, we're back here at DevOps 2014 and I'm here with Felipe. Hello.
Hello, Alexis.
And we're here to talk about big data. You're our big data guy, and maybe more specifically BigQuery, and that is one of the things you were talking about yesterday at the conference.
Yes, exactly. We did a presentation with Thomas Park from the BigQuery team. He's a software engineer, and we presented one of the new features of BigQuery, the user-defined functions.
Okay, so before we get to that, I think that is absolutely a very nice feature that is coming along really well. What is BigQuery?
Okay, BigQuery is a Google product in the cloud that serves to, it's useful to analyze data really, really fast. It's zero configuration, you just need to load your data to BigQuery, and then you can query it in seconds using just SQL.
So interactive time is what we call it. So it's not, you know, don't wait for a batch to run all night and get a result. So you can iterate, that's the addictive part of BigQuery, is you can like tweak it. How do you query it?
It's just using SQL.
Okay.
And the great feature of BigQuery is that you don't need to care about indexing your tables. It just runs fast wherever arbitrary query you write. It will do full table scans in seconds.
Right, so this is big data. I don't do big data, so why should I care about this? I don't have big enough data sets, right? So.
If you have been using tables, databases, if you have been writing SQL queries, you've had frustrations, probably.
Yes, I think that is fair to say.
Yeah, so if you have ever seen a query taking minutes or hours to run, with BigQuery you can take the same time to seconds.
So you're saying if I have long-running SQL queries, I'm doing big data, I just don't know it.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Okay, great.
Also, BigQuery is awesome if you want to share data. If you have data that you want to share with more people, BigQuery has strong access controls that let you share that data immediately with other people without them needing to set it up.
So. Okay, that's very good. So SQL, everybody knows SQL, so upload your data, start querying results in a matter of few seconds, that's great. So to introduce that user-defined function feature that you mentioned to start with, that means there's some limitation probably in SQL as a querying language. What are those limitations?
So yeah, I love SQL. It allows me to write 95% of my questions, but sometimes it's not enough. Sometimes you want something more of a procedural language to transform the data, to analyze it. But at the same time, you want the power of BigQuery to go over the full table in seconds. So the question is, how do we get a procedural language to work in the same massive cluster that BigQuery has to analyze data?
Uh-huh.
That's why the BigQuery team, Thomas, is adding this new feature, the user-defined functions, where you can write in JavaScript any arbitrary function you would like that runs inside the cluster within your SQL query.
So one of the things you were able to do with BigQuery is run regular expressions. Embed regular. So now I could, instead of a regular expression, have a full JavaScript function actually computing stuff?
Exactly. So
wow.
One of the examples we ran yesterday, we were processing logs. And sometimes logs have URL encoded information, or sometimes
information. Data is never clean, right?
Yeah. So regular expressions are limited in what they can do.
Yes.
But if you can add a JavaScript filtering inside your SQL query that cleans up your data, however you might want to do it, it's there now.
So how is this implemented? Do you get a performance hit? Because are you still in interactive time? Where is this executed? Yeah. Tell us a little bit about how this is implemented.
Yeah. So one of the questions that people ask us is, why JavaScript? Why did we choose that language?
Yeah, that's also a valid question.
Well, it turns out at Google we also developed a very fast JavaScript environment.
I think I've heard of something called V8.
V8, yeah. Exactly. So we took the exact V8 from Chrome and we put it inside the BigQuery cluster, so each node is running V8 and your JavaScript functions run inside its node.
And probably it's worth mentioning here that, you know, the reason BigQuery is maybe more than a product but a service is that Google does all the heavy lifting. So we run the cluster, we set everything up. Obviously, it's distributed. This is the only way you can get, you know, give us maybe an idea of the amounts of data that can be processed in a matter of a few seconds. The data you used yesterday, for example.
Yeah, so one of my favorite examples are the Wikipedia logs.
Yes.
They have billions of rows each month. And I'm able to query it during the presentation several times in seconds and just keep changing the queries to try different stuff and learn different.
And so when you do add those user-defined functions, you know, is the performance getting a whole lot worse? Are we like back to?
There is a performance hit,
of course.
There is communication between processes, but only inside the inside one node instead of going outside, so it's much faster. But we could still run all our queries
in interactive time. Still.
Interactive time, yeah.
Yeah, that's very exciting. When can we get our hands on this? Yeah. Is this coming?
Yeah, it's coming.
It's not just a prototype. It's actually
right now it's not available publicly yet, but several people are testing it. And if you have any use case that would be very nice to test with us, just call us and we will enable the user-defined function for you.
Your name is Felipe Hofa, and this is the guy you want to ping if you want to have an early access to this. Mm-hmm. And certainly keep an eye on this new feature in the cloud platform from Google, specifically in BigQuery, user-defined functions. Thanks for the time.
Thank you very much, Alexis.
And we'll see you online. Cheers.